अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स योर मैथ्स क्लास एंड वी आर लर्निंग कैम्ब्रिज चेक पॉइंट मैथ्स 3 एज वी हैव स्टार्टेड चैप्टर नंबर 2. सो टुडे वी विल डू एक्सरसाइज 2.2A फ्रॉम आवर बुक दैट इज अबाउट कंस्ट्रक्टिंग एक्सप्रेशन. सो एंड यू नो दैट व्हाट इज एक्सप्रेशन? यस, एन एक्सप्रेशन इज यूज टू रिप्रेजेंट अ वैल्यू इन एल्जेब्रिक फॉर्म. So whenever we write something in algebraic form, this is called expressions. You can see its definition from here, and even how we construct expressions, they have explained on page number 19. So if we will say in this example, this is that the boxes contain red, yellow, blue and green counters, and we use R for red, Y for yellow, B for blue and G for green. And if there are 4 full boxes of red, then it will be 4R. 3 full boxes of yellow will be 3Y. 5 of blue means 5B. And 6 of green means plus 6G. And 25 extra counter means plus 25. So you can see that we have constructed an expression. So it's really very easy to do. You can do it very easily. Now let's see one example from exercise 2.2A. 6 full boxes of red counters means 6R. 2 of blue means plus 2B. And 8 green means plus 8G. You see, it's same as they have explained in the examples. Next are also the same. So you can do it with your own. I will explain the last one, that is a half box of each color. Now I don't know how many colors, so I will write X instead of any color or any number. So a half of X means how many color I will have. I have to count the half of them. See the example. For example, I have 10 colors. So a half of 10 will be 5. Okay, because I don't know how many colors, that's why I write X instead of 10. It may be 12, it may be 14 or any other number, or a 7 or a 6 or any other number. So it is easy for us to do with the X. Clear? So because we are constructing expression, and in constructing expression we must have sometimes an unknown values too. So that's why I write X on the in place of an unknown, which is each color. Clear? Now let's have a look from our workbook too. If you see page number 10 of your workbook, the first question is 2 boxes of red from which 5 counters have been removed from each box, and then the remaining number has been tripled. Now how many boxes? 2 of which color? Red. So how will I write 2R? And I have to subtract 5 counters minus 5 is equal to, the remaining number has been tripled. So we know that unknown value we can write X, Y or any alphabet. So I used to write X, that's why I am writing X. And the remaining number has been tripled, so it will be multiplied by 3. Clear? So my answer is 2 into R minus 5 is equal to 3X. You can write in another way. This same question you can write in another way. For example, they said 2 boxes of red and 5 counter have been removed from each box. So it will be R minus 5, that is box 1. Then R minus 5, which is box number 2. And the answer is 3 into X. Either you will write in this form or in this form, it's same. It doesn't matter a lot. Clear? Okay, let's have another example. 3 boxes of blue. Now we will do same. 3 boxes of blue from which 2 counter have been removed means minus 2, and the remaining will be multiplied by X. So it will be 5X. You can write in this way also. So you see, it's really very easy to do. Now let's move to question number 2, that is writing an expression for the area and a perimeter for of each of the rectangles. You know what is the area of rectangle? What is the formula of finding area? It's length into width. Clear? So they have given b plus 1 multiply by 3a. You can put the bracket or not, it's up to you. Clear? Or you can write in the way b plus 1 and now let's move to the question number 2, in which we have to write an expression for the area and perimeter of each of the following rectangle. So you know what is the formula of finding area and perimeter? So finding the area of rectangle, what is the formula? L into width. And for finding the perimeter, we do 2 into L plus B. Clear? Now you just have to remember this formula. Okay, now see question number 1, that is B. If I will write an expression for this question, that is question number 2 part A, and I will write area, what I need to do? B plus 1 multiply by 3A. Or you can write it in the way like B plus 1 and 3A. This is the area of this rectangle. Okay, now if I want to write the perimeter, what I need to do is, I know the formula, so I will multiply 2 and the length b plus 1 plus second is 3a. Okay, so this will be my answer. Clear? I hope you got this. And you will put it over here. You have to do same in all these questions. Even if you will see from your book, that is page number 20, you have to do all same. Now you just need to do that for your easiness. If there is one line, it means it's a value of 3. So here we also have one line, so it's 3. Length is 3 here and 3 here, and the two lines means n, so it is also an n and n. So you will construct n, but you have to form the only perimeter in these questions, in this and this. So it's s plus 2t, it is also s plus 2t, it is also s plus 2t. So perimeter means perimeter also means that the sum of all sides. So you can also write like 3 plus n plus 3 plus n, or you can just count 1, 2, 3, 4 times 3 plus 1, 2, 3, 4 times n. So it will be also construct the formula of perimeter, because perimeter's formula is also that sum of all sides, or the other formula I have written over here. Thank you so much, Allah Hafiz. And if you will have any problem, you can ask in your class.